In this video of our simulator preparation for airline assessment series, we go over instrument flying skills. This is a brief video where we just go over which parts of your instrument training you must revise and come with at your assessment. Let's move on to instrument flying skills. So it's about your spatial orientation, obviously, because you're going to take off and then you're going to do some evolutions, and then it's easy to get disoriented. And most people do. I probably would as well after a while. If you get anyone to turn many times, this and climb, you know, you're focused on approaching your heading and all of that. You know, it would be good if you could develop a situational awareness to look at your needle and to have an idea of where you are. Usually the VOR will be located on the airfield. So there's always a VOR on an airfield. It's very rare that there's not. Like Dubai doesn't have one, for instance, anymore, but it's very rare. And usually there's always a beacon on an airfield. And so you should know where you are. And so your instrument flying is expected to be good from a recently qualified student pilot. Okay, so you should know how to intercept a radial and an ILS axis, navigate and hold to a beacon and hold at an intersection, which is a bit tricky. You should be able to fly an Arc DME. So it's rarely requested, but the Arc DME is a great way for you to be able to return to an airfield if they tell you everything is failed and you don't have a chart, you can't do a procedural approach. Great, it's a thing you should know how to do. And you should be able to fly a circuit with a fully functional 737. And you should be able to do all of that raw data, APFD, ATHR, auto throttle off. Okay. So it's a bit complicated if you don't know the SOP. So put that one between brackets. Now, if you're experienced, you'll be expected to do that, of course, also with a fully functional plane, but then you'll be expected also to do an engine failure after V1 and stuff like that. I hope you enjoyed this short segment. In Sim Preparation course, we detail this greatly, giving you a much more practical approach to instrument flying than the one you probably learned at flight school. You need to sacrifice mathematical precision for situational awareness. That's what we do as airline pilots, and that's what we encourage you to develop as a mindset as you approach your selection. Now, the Sim Preparation course adds a lot of operational knowledge. I like to say it's a Sim Preparation and Operational Knowledge course. I think it's a really great course to start to really understand what is the life of an airline pilot on top of learning how to fly the plane. So again, I will invite you, I'll give you a QR code in a second. You can go and check the video I've recorded there to explain the detail of the course. And this is the QR code where you can get the course now. Okay, you can download our app as well. If you want to contact me directly, you can. I go on Discord. Come and see us on Discord. You can subscribe and like the channel. It will be a pleasure to get to see you again very soon.